Hello. Now, regarding the bombings on 77 London, these two chaps were unfortunately involved in it. As you can see, the guy on the right has lost his legs, and the guy on the left is the guy who helped him, a military man. Now, they're on This Morning with Schofield and whoever the other bimbo is. Now, I'll set it playing in a second, and you'll see what the controlled media does with people who actually want to get the truth out. Now, they've come on, not with an agenda, they've come on to be questioned about stuff, but they've come on with a viewpoint of pointing out that there are a lot of questions that weren't covered by the so-called inquiry. Now, you'll notice the chap who's lost his legs, I'm afraid I don't know his name, I think it's Adrian Biddle. He, on a few occasions during this, tries to get his point across, and you'll notice that he is shut down. They go to adverts, they actually end the interview. Anyway, I'll just show the preamble as Schofield starts asking him another question, and you'll see what I mean. Okay.
Tunnel, as you say, you're grateful because he saved your life, and you say, please don't be grateful, I just happened to be there at the right time, which we can understand. In a matter of seconds, I'm about to pass through the work that you went forward with to rehabilitate yourself, your physiotherapy, the pain, the anguish, the learning to walk with prosthetic legs, deciding that the wheelchair is actually more comfortable, the fact that you didn't think that your girlfriend would ever want to marry you, and she slapped your arm and said, don't be stupid, of course I want to marry you, and you did marry, and you did have your baby. And there am I, look what I've just done. You know, I've just gone through the hardest time of your life in a matter of seconds, and I'm sorry, but that's the nature of live telly. But as you sit here now and look back on that day, and you've had the public inquiry, is there any sort of closure on this?
No, I mean, for me, the inquest just kind of threw up more questions than it was ever going to answer. I think it was a one-time opportunity to really say, look, mistakes were made, this is how the mistakes were made, and correct it. And when I was giving my evidence and watching the media coverage of the inquest kind of right up to the end, and
I want to pause you there for just a second. We've got to take a commercial break. Will you stay here for a second, and we'll come back after just a case of this?
Now, did you see what happened then? Did you see what happened then? The little ticker in the corner there came up. As someone in the control room said, go to adverts, he's talking about the inquiry, he's talking about the actual facts of the thing. So, see, this is what really pisses me off. Now, if I fast-forwarded it through, sure enough, they do come back to him, and nothing is asked about the previous question, which was so obviously so important to this guy. That doesn't come up again until the end of the interview when he brings it up again. And I'm sorry, we've got to end it there, the nature of live TV. Now, did you notice how they tried to turn it into almost like a chat magazine thing where they showed pictures of his wedding and talked about his life and this, that and the other? And that's the nature of these shows, I understand that. But this guy had something to say, and every time he tried to say it, they went to adverts, they shut him down, they changed the conversation, and they ended the interview. Now, if you cannot see that this is complete mind control, then I really do pity you. I don't know. Anyway, I've waffled on for 4 minutes. I'll let you make your own conclusions. Thanks for watching.